Westminster Abbey is a grand and beautiful church. With its strong stone walls, it feels very safe. It's very, very different to the place in our story. Mary and Joseph had had a long journey to Bethlehem, and when they got there, they struggled to find anywhere to sleep. Lots of people were in Bethlehem on the same journey as them. Joseph really needed to find a safe place for Mary to have the baby. They reached the last door of the last inn, and Joseph gave a heavy, tired knock. The innkeeper opened the door and said, "There is no room at the inn." He was just closing the door when he caught sight of Mary, looking tired and heavy. He smiled and said, "Actually, there is somewhere you could stay. Do you know where that was?" "It was a stable." "Do you know what a stable is? Is it the best room in the inn?" "No, it's where the animals sleep." And it was there, among the hay and the animals in the warmth, that the baby, Jesus, was born. Mary wrapped him in cloths, and because there was no crib for him to sleep in, she laid him in the manger, which is where the animals eat their hay from. Even in these humble surroundings, it was a very, very special night.
Who is the most important person in the world? Could it be the President of the United States? Or the Queen? Or perhaps your mum or dad? They're all important in their way. But how can you tell that someone is important? Well, important people often live in big houses, don't they? They drive around in big cars or fly in fast jets. They have lots of followers on Instagram. They wear really nice clothes. And when they talk or tweet, everyone listens. So here's a strange thing. When the most important person who ever lived came into the world, he was born in a smelly shed, surrounded by straw and animal poo. His mum didn't have a proper bed for him, so she put him in the trough where the animals ate their food. And when he opened his mouth, all that came out were gurgles and screams. And who wants to listen to that? If Jesus was the most important person who ever lived, if he was the Son of God, God with us, God just like us, then why didn't he come like a normal important person? The answer, we're told, is love. If he had come to us like a normal important person, rich and powerful, then he wouldn't be like most of us. I don't know about you, but while I really like my flat, it isn't a palace. And I love my car, but if you saw it, you would realise it is really, really small. And when I look on the telly or online and see people who don't have enough to eat, or whose homes have been destroyed by war or by the effects of climate change, I bet they don't feel rich or powerful. They probably don't feel very important either. So Jesus doesn't come to us like a normal, important person. He comes to us like a normal person. More than that, he comes to us like a poor person. And he does that because he wants to be God with us. God just like us. Not God strutting around like a rich and powerful person telling us what to do, but God alongside us, close to us, close to everyone, no matter how ordinary or poor they may be. He wants to get really, really close so that we can know, without a shadow of a doubt, that he loves us.
heard earlier in the story about the baby Jesus being born. I wonder, have you ever held a baby? I wonder how Mary and Joseph felt that night. What did they hear and smell? What did they feel? What did they see? The crunch of hay underfoot, the fur of the animals as they brushed past them. That stable was full of love that night. I wonder how you could show somebody that you love them today.